name I pray. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. You can sit down. You didn't notice, I said, in Jesus' name I pray. And then I now said, tell me what I said later. You need to understand where I'm coming from. And when you are under training, and you are getting the training, and somebody there has been trained even today. I said you have been trained even today. I remember the first crusade we had in Lagos, and we were at the stadium. And when you think about the stadium, there are thousands of people, tens of thousands, and filled up. And at that time, I was, just at the beginning of having crusades, with conferences. I've been kind of a teacher since I was, even before I became born again, I was a teacher. Then I became born again, I was a teacher. Sanctified, I was a teacher. Holy Ghost baptized, I was a teacher. Deeper life started, I was a teacher. And I went on as a teacher. And now crusade came. And now you have to add something. Something is added to your life today. And they have been announcing, we got a professional media person that publicized everywhere. And he didn't do anything. All he wanted was to fulfill the contract we gave him. Because we gave him the contract so publicized that to draw the whole city to the stadium. And that is what he did. But then he said, blind eyes will open, the lame will walk, and this will happen, that will happen. And then I said, look at what we've done. We've invited this man to publicize, and now he's gone beyond what we wanted. And then our people took it up, the palate members, they took it up, they said, blind eyes will open, and the lame will walk, and this will happen. I said, what are these people doing? And we didn't invite an international evangelist to come and take it. They thought that I was the fellow to take all that. I didn't show it on my face, but in my heart I said, God, help me here. And so eventually we got to the stadium, and those people, they believed the publicity. And they believed everything was said, or they said, I didn't say it, everything they said at the, inviting the people. And, I saw the wheelchairs coming in, and I saw all that, and blind people. And then I was in the car, so I, turned away my eyes from there. I didn't want, that side to disturb the little faith that I knew I was going to talk to them on salvation. And salvation I will talk about. And but all these people, they were wheeling in. I said, this, something is going to happen today. Now, eventually, I, preached the message. I talked about Jesus. And, Jesus is all in all. I said, Jesus will save you. I didn't say I will save them. Jesus will heal you, of course. I didn't say I will heal them. And Jesus will deliver you. I didn't say I was going to, deliver them. And then it came to the time, and they believed all that. They believed that Jesus will save. Do you believe? Yes. And they believed that Jesus will heal. Do you believe that? And so eventually, the time came, and I made the altar call, and people responded, and I saw thousands of fans responding. They wanted to get saved. But I knew they were still waiting for something. And so eventually, I said, take the names. It's wonderful, and we did everything followed up. And they were now going to expect that those people, they wheeled in, that something will happen. And I said, what am I going to do now? So I now said, we're going to pray. Everybody, you stand up. Don't stand up. I'm just telling the stories to you. And eventually I said, now, if you are sick, you're blind, you're lame and all that, here we are praying. We're praying in the sense that, we're all praying. If nothing happens, not my fault. And so I said, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray. And then I went on, and before I finished, I've not finished the prayer, I had a shout. Somebody there, their eyes got opened. And then another person there came out of the child. The child, one leg did not have any bone at all. It was like rubber. And one, now the stick. And then I said, as we pray in the name of the Lord, receive your healing. God created a bone there. And the mother ran out, and the mother was dancing and rejoicing. Then when I heard the shout, I opened my eyes. I saw what was happening. And then I said, in the name of Jesus, I pray. Because now, even at that time, I came a step higher. Somebody there is coming a step higher. And eventually now we've gone to, you know, different places. We've gone to all the states, you know, in Nigeria. Even within this short time that Mommy Esther came into my life, she said traveled to all the states in Nigeria. And she's gone to local governments in Nigeria. Anywhere you mention Nigeria, now she'll tell you, yes, that's what it is, that's where it is, and all that. And as we have traveled around, you know, some things have happened. I'm telling you this so that you will understand that, you know, when God is training a person, he now, when he comes to minister to you, maybe you saw him 10 years ago, 15 years ago, and the way he ministered 15 years ago is to, you know, talk about healing, talk about faith, and talk about miracle, and then come to you personally, and then sit down there with you and say, you know, my sister, this will happen, my brother, this will happen, and then I take 30 minutes with you as an individual, and I now say, let us pray. All that we're doing at that time is to make you have the faith so that you can, you know, get it yourself. But now I've gone for training. Are you there? Am I talking to somebody there today? I've gone for training now, and as I've gone for the training, you know, the Lord has, you know, brought me to another level. So that I don't have to, you know, talk on healing. I don't have to talk. I can talk on the difference. I can talk to you on the coming of the Lord and on the rapture. And then not mention healing at all. And then when I finish and I say, let us pray. If I wanted to, you know, just give it to you. It's like, you know, I got something. And then, now that I've got it, I'm not going to go and search for the thing. I'm a, you know, distribution. I say, get your own, get your own, get your own. It wasn't like that many years ago, but today it is like that. And, you know, sometimes, you know, when I normally give my testimony, I don't have to see somebody to, you know, corroborate and, you know, to see, is it true, is it not true? Because I know you believe me. Anybody there? Who is it there that believes me? Okay, God bless you. But all the same, I'm just telling you that, you know, we went to Taraba State. I can almost call Mommy Esther to come up here and say, is that true? And then she'll tell you that it's true. But look at this. We went to Taraba State. And as we go to Taraba State, the stadium was filled up. And then we have this child, 23 years of age. She was sitting on a board. And you have little tires under that board. And then she'll sit on it. That's the only way she could move, because the hands were paralyzed, the feet were paralyzed from birth, 23 years of age. And then I didn't have to go to them and touch them one by one and say, okay, you come, they line up. And then I said, over there, the Lord is touching you now. And then we'll pray, not up to 5 minutes. They say it's simple and short and straightforward. And then as we prayed like that, this boy, this child, 23 years, you know, that something got up, raised up the board and said, this is what I was chasing before, and he walked majestically, you know, before everybody. And we didn't have to touch. But you see, that's not the end of the story in Taraba State. We finished that night, and I was to get to the car. As before I got to the car, there were 3 or 4 paralyzed people on the mat. And they put them there near the door of the car for me to enter. And when the chief security officer saw that, because we have security in large crowds like that, he was challenging the people. Why did you allow these people here? You know, they're going to disturb the chairs. They won't allow him to enter. So I said, carry them away. I said, no, leave them there. Paralyzed, they couldn't do anything. And I was about to enter the car, and I wasn't about to start preaching and praying again. So I said, God bless you. You're healed. Rise up. You're healed. Rise up. I didn't touch them. You're healed. Rise up. And they were there. And then we entered into the car and drove off. As we were getting to the gate of that whole premises at the stadium, we heard a shout. And then we stopped, and then we found out. Number one got up. Number two got up. Number three got up. This is what has been happening. And so, whether I talk on healing or not, and whether I come to you or not, just as our pastor moderating said, I catch your eyeballs. And you catch my eyeballs. And as we interact together by faith, there's an explosion in your life. It will happen. I said it will happen. So, if I say, in Jesus' name we pray, hold on, when I say we, I'm hanging on what Christ said, that if you and I will agree as touching anything that we ask, you and I, that's we. Is that, is my grammar correct? When I say we pray and we agree, it must happen. Yeah. But if I excuse you, I don't want to bother you, and I go to another verse that says, if you, that's me now, say to this mountain, be thou removed. I'm not asking you to help me now. When I say we, you and I will be together. Amen. When I take it personally, and it says, if I say to this mountain, that mountain over there, Amen. Be thou removed, Amen. And be cast, not in your backyard when you see it later after 1 month, but be cast into the sea, I will have whatsoever I say. And so, when my age go this direction, I pray it's done. Yeah. When my come this direction, we pray and it's done. Yeah. In a good UK, amen. Yeah. And so, we're going to have the word now. After the word, I'm just telling you what's on the menu. So you understand, you don't run away after this one comes and that one comes. After the message, another person is going to come and lead you in prayer. That's the menu. After he has led you in prayer, on the basis of what we're preaching, I will not run away. I'm still going to sit down there. When he finishes and you finish your own beat, I'm coming back. When I come back, it may be we, it may be I, but whether I or we, mountains will move. And after we have finished that, we don't need to, you know, come again. I want to see the cheers. If you want to see me, look up here now. This is the time to see me. My children, do you accept? Don't worry about, you know, I will still preach, but I think I need to help you. Hello. I was traveling. If you've heard it before, act as if you've never heard. You know, sometimes you're telling somebody a story, and you forgot you had told him the story before. And then he looks at you and said, I heard that before. You take my excitement away when you do that. But when I'm telling you a story you've heard before, you act as same, Pastor. Tell me. Put the quotation marks there. It happened like this, happened like that. And then after you show all that excitement, you know, somebody told me that, do you know that sister had heard that story before? I said, that's a good sister. She made my day. She acted as if she was sailing for the first time. So, you know how to act? How are you going to act now? You are hearing for the first time. Maybe you've never heard. While I was traveling, I was changing planes. And I had my hand luggage with me. I was traveling alone at that time. And somebody ran after me in Paris, that's France. I said, Pastor Kumuyi, Pastor Kumuyi. I said, yes, I look back. He said, I wanted to have an appointment with you. I said, where? In Nigeria? Those soldiers, the militants, give me the appointment now and sign it here so that when I get to Nigeria, I'll show them that you give me an appointment. I said, what's the appointment for? And we're walking, you know, from one plane to the other. And she said, I've been married for so many years and there's no child. I said, that's what you need appointment for. I said, in the name of Jesus, our eyes open because we are, you know, at the tarmac. In the name of Jesus, receive your miracle. Amen. Praise the Lord. You've got it. No appointment. The appointment was there. Your appointment is... And so, we got back to Nigeria about 1 year after she came to Bagada. Have you heard of Bagada before? That Bagada is not the one you knew. This one is new Bagada, new generation Bagada, state of the art Bagada. You must be there at least once in your lifetime. I'm serious. You must be in Bagada at least once in your lifetime. That place, preaching there is awesome. Amen. Okay, apart from advertisement, about 1 year after she came to Bagada, and she said, Pastor, you know me? I said, I meet many people. I'm not sure I can recognize you. He said, do you remember somebody who said she wanted appointment? I said, yes, I know that now. She said, you prayed for me just walking, not even closing her eyes, not kneeling down. And you said, the Lord should give me the miracle baby. I came to tell you, Pastor, here is the miracle baby. That's how UK people clap. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. And so, if things have been happening like that, don't get us back to primary school praying. We're now beyond university level. Postgraduate. You believe? If your children go to primary, secondary, college, university, and then they build their doctorate, and they go beyond the doctorate, and now they are professors, who do you think I should remain in the primary school of prayer? Remain in the primary school of ministration. Things must change. I must be up there. And I'm taking you up there with me. You're not remaining in the primary school of ministration all the time. Now, see. Going around in Nigeria, not this time now. Mumbesa was not there this time. This one is new to her. This one, we're going around. And we got to a particular place, and the boy was lame, paralyzed. And the mother was, you know, going around a particular porch they put upside down, her God, her idol. And the people there said, look at this woman, let's pray for the child. I said, don't be in a hurry, hold on. I'm telling you the same thing, don't be in a hurry, hold on. And so the woman finished, and I said, I'm sure you heard the story before. Don't say I heard it before, but you know, just pay attention. Say it, I'm listening. And then, I said, Mama, what's this? Oh, that's my God. And I'm worshiping my God. I said, which one is your God? And she pointed at that pot that was sort of, I said, your God, look at what your God has done to your child. If you come to my God, I'm going to pray for that child, and that child will get up. And she said, okay, pray. If you pray for my child and this child gets up, she said, I'm going to abandon my God. I said, no, you will do yours first, and then I'll pray for the child. He said, but she had not met you before. What if I throw away my God, and then you pray for my child, and the child does not get up, and I've lost that, and then my God is gone? I said, no, I'm a teacher. The students don't dictate to the teacher how we teach. I do. I prepare the curriculum. I prepare the lesson and everything. Just pay attention to me. Throw away that thing and this child will get up. And thank God she listened to me like you are listening to me. Yeah. Anybody listening to me there today? Yeah. And so she took up that thing, you know, and the thing was empty, an empty God. There was nothing, you know, under that pot, and threw it away and broke it. A God that is breakable is not a God. And then after she broke that thing, I didn't touch the child. The child didn't understand the English. I didn't understand their local language. I was speaking to the woman through an interpreter. And now I say, in the name of Jesus, boy, get up. And the boy got up. Yeah.